I'm privileged to have in the studio, that's Mr. Chris Essilfie, he's the chef de mission. If you're wondering who chef de mission is, he is more or less the leader of delegation. I remember very well when we went to the All Africa Games in Congo Brazzaville, the chef de mission was Mr. Sakakwe, and he led the team. He was the leader of delegation. We went there and he made sure that everything was well. Sir, thanks so much for joining me here.
Thank you very much for having me.
Well, let's start from where Professor Dodo ended. You know, he spoke about how some people are saying that we can't go for the games because of fans. What was the story?
I think it's, to begin with, a very unfortunate statement, whoever made it. Because I'm sure the person is not well-versed or the person doesn't understand how these things work. And what is happening now is not current. That's what I should say. Yes, we do have challenges in terms of the way we support our sporting disciplines apart from football. But we are at a stage where you can't just make such a statement when really you are not on the ground, you don't understand what is happening. I don't think that we are at a situation where we can say we're going to pull out. No, we are not there. Even taking your mind off what is happening, look at athletes who have prepared, some have even qualified. Mm-hmm. You can't just say you are pulling out. I mean, based on what? I think it's a very unfortunate statement.
But the fact is that you know, fans has been a major problem for the sporting federations. As we speak now, I remember very well just last week, the Taekwondo team came back from their qualifiers and the GOC had to support them. Nothing from government. So how are we going to do this?
Yes, it's the truth. I mean, it's a responsibility, like you all know, it's the responsibility of government to support the federations. Mm. You see, anytime we talk about government supporting the federation, there's a certain misconception. Mm. Federations are doing so well. They don't need government money or they don't want necessarily government money to develop their sports. But at least when a national team is selected, that is the government's responsibility.
It becomes a responsibility
exactly.
of government, yeah.
So at that point when they've selected their national teams, if they have to go for qualifying competitions and all that, it's the responsibility of the government. Mm. Yes, we are at a point where the government hasn't supported, but there's a lot of discussions going on. So the GOC at this point is trying to support these federations who have a possibility or more a higher probability of qualifying to go for their qualifying series, and so that we can see that we can get a number of people to go for the real
games. You know, one thing that triggered, you know, that comment from Professor Dodo to, you know, come out and speak about how he feels that we'll still go for the competition is because of, you know, stories making rounds that, well, only one athlete has qualified now. That's Alex Amankwa for athletics. So if we've not had enough athletes going into the games, why should we even bother going at all? What is the real situation? Okay. What are you guys going to do to ensure that we get massive representation in Brazil?
Okay, again, when you say that one athlete has qualified now, it has nothing to do with whether 100 athletes will qualify or 2,000 athletes will qualify. Qualifying athletes is a science. Mm-hmm. It's not humanities. Mm-hmm. So there's a structured approach to look at how athletes are going to qualify. What I mean by that is that various federations have their various competitions and there's a cutoff point where athletes will qualify. As I speak to you now, a lot of them have to go. In fact, the last cutoff point, this will be athletic somewhere in June.
Yeah, in June.
So
yeah.
Till they get to June, you can't say only one athlete has qualified. It is not a straight line graph to say that, yes, we are 7 months, so you should expect 30 to qualify. Yes, some countries, if we had had money to go around everywhere, maybe we would have had more. But the fact that we have one now has nothing to do with whether 20 or 100 will
qualify. But you know, see, we have the table tennis team. They'll go for their qualifiers. Yeah. Also, weightlifting, they have their qualifiers to go for. And we've already noted about the athleticism. Yeah. Are you sure by this time till maybe, let's say, May, June, we'll have massive representation in Brazil?
Well, I'll come back to what I said. Mm. If you rightly say that table tennis are not going, you are leaving tomorrow.
Yeah.
I think you are competing on Sunday.
Yeah.
And weightlifting also has to go.
Yeah.
Others will go. Shooting, everything, they all have to go. Yes. You know, what you have done is that we've had a series of meetings with all these federation presidents, and we have narrowed it down as to, look, it's not just about sending the numbers even out there, because if GOC is supporting, we are looking at the cream. I mean, the quality that we believe have the potential to qualify. And they have, some of them have even decided, only one person, two people, or three people. These are people that you are very sure they have the potential to qualify. So definitely, yes, between now and June, we would have a lot more athletes to qualify.
Challenges. And the major challenge has been about money. Do we have the funds to go?
To go for the games or for the qualifiers?
For the qualifiers, because we have to qualify before we go for the games.
Definitely. I'm happy you are. Some people will talk about the games when you're talking about qualifiers. It's a starting point. Yes, and like I told you, yes, we've had challenges. There's still some discussions going on. But in the meantime, the GOC is trying to support all the federations who have the potential to qualify to go for their qualifying series and see how they can qualify.
So how are we doing it? I remember very well that Professor Dodu some time back told me that for him, he wants us to do this categorization where we look at the ones that have the potential to go. So do we have, let's say, category A, we are looking at athletics, tennis, category B, we are looking at this sport, because obviously we know football is not going to make it, so football is out.
Yeah.
So the other disciplines, how are we doing it in terms of, you know, funding for these guys to go for their qualifiers?
Where we sit right now, the categorization proposal has been on the table, but it's not been done.
Mm-hmm.
I think the sports authority tried doing something of a sort some time back, which we thought was a laudable idea, but it's not been done. But basically, that is the way we're looking at how the government will have to fund the federations anyway, because the challenge also is that there are a lot more federations that have sprung up. And so the question is, do we really fund every federation to go for all kinds of games and competitions? Maybe no, maybe yes. So if the federations have been categorized, and then you know that Federation A has the potential of doing A, B, C, D, then in terms of funding, if we really have to put our weight behind, even if it's one federation we put our weight behind to go and win as medals, then we'll do so. I mean, for instance, look at boxing. So far, we've had 4 medals in the history of Olympics. Boxing is 1-3. Football is 1-1.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? And yet Ghanaians want to glorify the football. Look, if I ask you right now to tell me about that team, the football team, you remember? You remember all of them?
Yeah, definitely.
But if I ask you to tell me about those three boxers, you might not even remember.
Yeah.
Why do we do so? All 23 or 24 players go and win one medal, and an individual wins a medal, three individuals win medals, and we don't remember them. So even if you have to go by that, if you're a businessman, then you look at your portfolio analysis, you see that, look, boxing is where I have to put my investment, because that is where I'll make the money. So I'm sure the categorization will iron out some of these things, and that will help. But for now, we don't have the categorization. And so any federation that, through its international federation and the standards they've set, they've made progress.
Mm-hmm.
You can't say that I'm not going to sponsor them or going to cut them off.
Well, you're still here on The Pulse this time. We're doing a special edition of the Sports here on Pulse. I'm Benedict Owusu, and my guest in the studio is Mr. Chris Essilfie. He's the chef de mission for Team Ghana as we go for the Rio Olympics. Well, this morning, you know, we spoke to Mr. Benigno Mensah. He's the president of the Ghana weightlifting team. Well, he noted clearly that his players or his athletes are not going to qualify for the Olympics, obviously he wouldn't want to waste his time. And for them, it's not even their priority to qualify athletes for the Olympics. He is looking at even getting more athletes for the youth games. And, you know, that's a comment coming from Mr. Benigno Mensah. He's one man who is so much into this. I remember some time back, he was even the chef de mission for the Commonwealth Games. He pulled out and he came in. And there's a man who is saying that for him, if he had the resources to give to athletes or to fund them for qualifiers, he wouldn't even look at the Rio Olympics, but rather would target the Youth Olympics, because he believes that going for the Olympics, we are just going to add to the numbers, we are just going to participate. And for him, he doesn't believe that even in his category, weightlifting, we'll win medals. What would you say to him?
Well, he has his point. If he's talking about his own weightlifters, he has his point, because in his weightlifters, maybe they are not ranked at a point where he believes they can qualify. And I told you, the qualification is a science.
Mm.
If you know, these days the world standards are clear.
Yeah.
If it's 100 meters and it's 10.3, the qualifying time, throughout the year, you know where you sit.
Mm.
You understand? If you are ranked 15th in the world, you are ranked 10th in the world, you know that when you go, definitely you hit the final, and it's anybody's game at the final.
But
In his case, if he's saying that he's not sure, if his athletes are not going to qualify, he thinks they need a lot more time to build up. I can understand if he doesn't want it. In any case, the fact that we have limited resources, all we are saying is that even if you are not sure, and I told you, some federations are saying we are sending only two.
Mm.
We are sending one because I believe only one has the potential to qualify, so we don't bother sending the second one. So I don't believe that is the whole idea of not any other federation there is not just trying to add to the numbers.
Okay.
For where we sit now, everybody feels that these are people who can have the potential to go in there and make an impact.
Commonwealth Games, we're in charge. We had issues. It's obvious and it's a fact, and we all have to admit to it. And also in Brazil. Well, what is it that, you've picked up from the organization of the Commonwealth Games in terms of our participation there and also London Olympics if we were not even there? What is it that you've picked up going into this one?
I would love to, since you said it's a fact, I want you to tell me, for instance, the Commonwealth Games, when I was in charge, what are the issues that you want to answer this?
Especially, we heard, some of the athletes talk about jerseys, kits, that we're not giving them on time, they had to travel there. All these issues came up.
Okay, then I can address this. Mm. That's very true. We had issues with, we didn't have issues with jersey, we had issues with equipment, more of equipment.
Yeah.
Now, again, the responsibility of the ministry to provide those things. And so before we left, there was that understanding that money was being transferred from here to London for them to purchase those
equipment.
Yes, but it should have been done way before we left. But they hadn't done it. So the whole idea was that they transfer the money there.
And that makes your job very difficult.
It makes it very difficult. In fact, I had many issues with the people at the High Commission and all that, trying to get these things for my people. I mean, you all know, even judo, they finished the fight before they had their gadgets. Badminton, table tennis were almost disqualified because they had to using somebody's bat and all that. Even the All African Games.
It's been a major problem because I was at the All Africa Games and the pole vault.
Yes. I was just going to come to that one.
Yes, Yamua pole vault. The guy arrived and there was nothing for him to train with. He managed to win us a medal. Yeah. And it's that practice where they believe that, okay, let the guy go. Well, he will go and he will perform magic.
It's unfortunate. That's what I'm saying. Look, the whole country as a nation, we need to change our thinking. Our thinking must change in the sense that we need to start defining sports, really what sports, not football. Because if everything goes to football, that's where we're going to have the challenge.
Exactly.
All these other things, like this young man you are talking about, for instance, he had to use the Tunisians
and
the two of them were competing for the final medal.
So he would have seen all his everything that he was going to do before
even
the game.
That's why even the punt, he could have gotten injured because, you see, these days it is designed specifically for an individual. So what he will use, his weight and everything, his height, is factored into the design of the pole.
So the basic point is that we'll definitely get athletes.
Oh, yes,
we
definitely
get Ghana, and it wouldn't just be Alex Amankwa.
No. It's look, anybody who says that doesn't understand what is happening. I'm telling you, these are done up to May, June. Some are going to Germany, all that up to May, June. Athletics, the cutoff point is in June. So you can't sit here and say one has qualified, then it's only one.
Okay. Go on.
No. So I'm saying that I'm very positive we'll get more athletes to qualify.
Well, I'm sure you've been to Brazil already. Yeah. What are the arrangements, the GOC and also yourself, you are making to ensure that when we get to Brazil, we wouldn't have issues?
Okay, Brazil, I've been to Brazil. Brazil is ready. Mm-hmm. I mean, as of, I think last week, we have about 15 test events left for all the day. 44 events, test events that were going to be held. I think only 15 were left. Four will be done in May, and that'll be the end of it. The facilities were all ready, and that's why they are testing. I went to the Games Village, 3,500 apartments, to look at where the athletes will be based. It's a very wonderful piece of work they've done there. Their road network system and everything. Their pre-games training camps, about 136 of them are based in Brazil itself. So Brazil is very ready. I think what pretty much my job and what GOC does is to see how best we can get there smoothly and safely. So the one key thing is to do with one accreditation. So the accreditation, we've already started entering data, putting data in the system, because one thing that we have as a challenge all the time is the data, delay in data entry.
And then you have to enter my data in as well, because you're going to Brazil.
I'm sure you always go to Brazil, but you know that when it comes to accreditation for the media, you do directly with the Games Federation.
Exactly. Let's talk about this. Now, the major concern all over the world is the Zika virus. Kenya just yesterday, hinted that they would even want to pull out. I mean, do you think that this is something we should also consider?
Let me correct that statement. Kenya didn't say they would want to pull out. They said if it becomes epidemic.
Of course,
if it's an epidemic, then it's virtually a worldwide thing, or the World Health Organization saying that we can't have it. Yes, understandably so. I'm sure if it gets there, we'll also take a decision whether we have to go or not. But what I can say to you is that I'm regularly updated on what is happening. I think the last discussion we had, there was an issue to get even mosquito nets for every athlete.
Well, that's not the problem.
Well,
you carry mosquito nets from Ghana to Brazil.
No, we are not carrying mosquito nets from Ghana. It's not a discussion here. This is a discussion between Ghana, myself, and Brazil. So they are trying to provide mosquito nets for athletes there. Now, I think that by the time they have said they have already started spraying all the four games locations, exactly. Spraying, and they continue spraying till time. They are also giving, in terms of advice, what we have to do to prevent mosquito bites and all that. So I believe that as we go along, if it gets to time where we believe it's not worth going and the whole world accepts, so we'll definitely also pull out. But for now, no one has said he's pulling out. Brazil said if it becomes, Kenya said if it becomes
Kenya,
epidemic. Yeah. So let's put in the right context.
You know, I'm positive, just as you are positive, that we'll get more athletes to Brazil. So let's say we get 20, 30 athletes to Brazil. Are you confident that we'll win medals? It wouldn't just be the norm where we'll go and participate and come?
I think that it's premature to start talking about medals. Once we have qualified, at least, and I've told you.
But no, you are positive that we'll go, and I'm saying I'm also positive.
Yeah, but let me go further. What I'm saying, once you've gotten athletes, you begin to look at where they are ranked in the world, and then you start talking about medals. But for now, some of them may be there. If a certain mark has to be hit, some of them may hit the mark for the very first time. Someone who has hit the mark and has been consistent is someone you can confidently say can win a medal, depending on where he's placed in the world ranking. So I'm saying it's too premature to say that now.
All right, okay. Well, thank you so much. But before I take leave of you, I mean, I can see that you've listed some things. Probably maybe you would want to go through some of the things you've listed so our viewers will also know what
it wasn't my intention to come and share this. Some of them are own private stuff. But I was going to talk about, I think I had here about that there's 11,000 athletes that I expected at the Games.
For the Games?
For the Games.
Okay.
And then with 206 national...
So how many athletes, Ghana, have you budgeted for? We're looking at how many athletes?
I am looking at, based on what all the federation presidents have projected, I am looking at 25 athletes at least.
25?
Yes.
Out of...
You are not that optimistic after all, the way you're smiling, but I can assure you, it won't come from me. It's coming from the federation president. I have no cause to doubt. Why are you saying Ghana? Haven't we had 42 before?
No, but we should always look at qualifying 100, 200.
Oh, is that what you're talking about?
Yeah,
that's
of
what you're
course.
Expecting.
Yes.
We've hit 9-9 for the last two Olympic Games.
Yeah. That...
Beijing 9. London 9.
Well...
And we are talking... No,
things have changed.
Yes.
It's a system, and we are growing. So we should not focus on getting more.
Look,
but, you know, looking at 25,
you
might as well sit at home and don't go.
No, I disagree completely. Don't forget that the Olympic movement is not just even a number of athletes you send. It's not even about winning medals. It's about participation.
Okay.
Okay. So it goes beyond that. Mm. One thing you've got to understand is that, yes, it's a process.
Okay.
Olympic Games, you don't show up one day and you qualify.
Yeah,
it's a whole process. I mean, we should have started way back. Some are targeting... Look, the reason why some countries can sit here and say in 2020 in Tokyo, I'll win 15 medals, is science completely, because he knows that you, Benedict, I'm bringing you up. From the way I'll bring you up, next year you hit a certain mark, next 2 years, and by the time you get there, you're consistently...
And that's exactly what you guys
consistently,
are doing.
That's exactly what we are trying to do, but it's been difficult because when you don't have the
money.
Funding... Yes, if you don't have the funding, the federation presidents
we'll
are trying.
We'll get the money. We'll pray and get the money. Well, thank you so much, Mr. Chris Essilfie, for joining us.
You're welcome.
Well, this has been a special edition of Sports Here on Pause. My name is Benedict Tosu. So enjoy the rest of the program after this short commercial break.